There is, or was, yesterday, a fascinating post at a blog called Legal Insurrection. The headline of the post is, "We just witnessed the media's test run to re-elect Barack Obama." If Republicans want to know exactly what not to do to win in 2012 and follow advice similar to that offered by David Frum as to why Sarah Palin should stop talking now about the false accusations that she was responsible for the Tucson shooting. David Frum said there's no one left in America that would blame her. Oh, really? Two polls show otherwise. CNN poll showing 35% of all people, 56 Democrats, 34 independents, believe Palin has a great deal or moderate amount of responsibility for the shooting. A public policy polling poll reflects that 26% of all people, 45% Democrats, 22% independents, believe Palin bears at least some responsibility for the shooting. Those are big numbers, considering that there's no evidence as of this date that Jared Loughner ever even saw the Palin electoral target map, which put Palin at the center of attacks over the shooting. The false connection of the Palin electoral target map to the shooting did not start in the mainstream media. As I have documented, the false connection started with bloggers at Daily Cause and Think Progress using Twitter to push the issue into the mainstream media within hours of the shooting with the help of their followers. The ruthless efficiency with which the left-wing blogosphere tied Palin to the shooting and the success of their efforts in equating Palin with mass murder is a lesson we should not forget. The Democrats and their mainstream media supporters were put back on their heels in 2010, and they're regrouping. And if regrouping requires falsely accusing a major Republican figure of complicity in mass murder and then amplifying that false accusation for several days in the face of contrary evidence, they'll do it. But it didn't stop for the accusation. When Palin tried to defend herself, she was savaged again in the mainstream media. Palin supposedly didn't issue a statement soon enough, or she issued it too soon. She was accused of using the term blood libel improperly by people who had used the term themselves in less dire circumstances. She was making it all about her. Her tone wasn't right. She didn't really feel what she was saying, so on and so on. Having created a false narrative of Palin's responsibility for the shooting, the mainstream media tried to deprive Palin of the ability to defend herself against the charges. And unfortunately, some who supposedly are on our side have jumped on that bandwagon. And all the while, Barack Obama stood back for days and let his supporters in the media rip Palin apart, much as he left it to his supporters to go after the Clintons during the primary, only then to proclaim that we don't really know why Jared Loughner did what he did. And the media narrative was how wonderful Obama was, how he helped heal the nation. Any Republican, I want you to listen to this. This is from the Legal Insurrection blog. Any Republican or conservative or Tea Party supporter who dumps on Palin in any way over the Tucson shooting or her defense of herself should just stop talking now. This isn't about Palin. It is about the mainstream media's desire to have Obama reelected at any cost and to take down any Republican candidate who stands in the way. We have witnessed the test run for how the left-wing blogosphere will target any and all Republican candidates and propel false narratives into the mainstream media, and how the mainstream media will take those narratives and run with them. If Palin is taken down politically over the Tucson shooting, there is not a single Republican candidate who can survive the coming onslaught. If this is the standard by which we are going to choose candidates, then the time has come to put thoughts of Republicans winning in 2012 to rest. Now, the point here is, if I might summarize, the left is terrified of her. The left knows that she would wipe the floor with Obama. Our intelligentsia on the right wing know that she would wipe the floor with Obama. That's what all of this means. There are smart people, quote-unquote, in both parties who want nothing to do with Palin precisely because of the threat she poses to their claim and hold on power. And so what the point of this is that if Republicans are going to sit by and watch Palin savage, they'd better be prepared to sit by and watch the next one get savaged, and the next one, because that's what's coming. If the Republicans cannot defend themselves over this kind of scurrilous, baseless, libelous charge, they got no business. I mean, they're not going to be able to elect anybody. If they'll shut up and be silent about this, if we've got Republicans like Fromm who will agree with the left-wing blogosphere and the mainstream media that Palin should shut up, she should stop defending herself, and it's a horrible travesty of justice what Palin did. If we're going to have Republicans sit around and give Obama credit for sitting by for 4 days while his allies try to take her out, then give a speech and get credit for the wonderful things he said about it, then we got more idiots in our party than we would want to know. We have useful idiots who are being played like a Stradivarius by the left wing, from Obama on down to the mainstream media to the left wing blogs. We've got people on our side, typified by Fromm, who are useful idiots who are being incorporated into their effort to destroy any Republican's chance for victory in 2012. I think we played a soundbite by Fromm yesterday who said, basically, forget the presidency. Let's go for down ballot success. Let's try to win back the Senate. Obama's going to get reelected. And I know a lot of people who think David Fromm is the answer for the Republican Party. Not us, folks. Other intelligentsia in the conservative movement so far. It's preposterous, of course. But it's a good point. If all the others, you know, name names, like Huckabee, Romney, Pawlenty, if all the others are going to sit around and watch this happen to their party by virtue of it happening to Palin, then they're just the next ones in line. And this is it's an excellent blog post, and it's exactly on the money. And this call for civility, they don't want us to be civil. They want us to be cowed. They want all of us to become Frommized. They want all of us to see the wisdom in saying that the Republicans are silly and defensive and maybe a little guilty in their own minds for even deigning to defend themselves on this scurrilous charge. You know, they want us cowed. And look what happens to cows.